Hey guys, how's everybody today? And so today it is November 19th, and so today it is Saturday. Ginger ale. And so today we are having wraps for dinner. This is using the rest of the rotisserie chicken that we have, and so this is basically the week, that is the day that is finishing off our first week back from vacation. And so, yeah. And so for munchies, I'm going to munch on this new Swiss Chalet brand of the Lay's chips. It is the from the gravy, their dipping sauce, the Chalet sauce. And so if you guys are not Canadian, so you guys probably do not know the Swiss Chalet is a Canadian restaurant chain, the chicken restaurant, the rotisserie chicken, and they are very popular for the sauce, and so a lot of people goes crazy for their sauce, so they made a new bag of chips, the flavor with that, so I finally able to get my hands on a bag at a store, so gonna try it for you guys, and so gonna let you guys know how it is. But however, out here in the Western Canada where we are, I'm chatting it up with my coworkers and stuff here and there, and they're like, over the time, it's like everybody's like saying, yeah, the Swiss Chalet seems to be going down, the down, the down, the down, the down. Like everybody seems to be having the same opinion about Swiss Chalet. Like, for me, honestly, though, like, at the mall that is behind our house, there's a Swiss Chalet at Montana's, and they are owned by the same corporation. So, basically, you're, like, spending the money to the same place anyways. I would rather go to the Montana's any day compared to Swiss Chalet. And at Montana's, I find they have the better deals and the better offers anyway, so. And it's like one of the more cooler restaurants that we have out here. Also, what I like about the Montana's is that they do this thing with the scene points, and they have better deals with the scene points. It's like the points that you can go to the movies with. Like, what was the deal last time? Was it we went there and it was like, was it you spend $60 for 600 points or something like that? I don't know. Something like that. And like, the Swiss Chalet, they always do these funny points. They like, 1 point for every how many dollar you spend or something. It's like you have to do math and stuff. It's like, whatever. Right? Is that the type of deals that the Swiss Chalet usually does? I'm excited. Let's get into this. I always smell them first when I get the new flavors. So far, it smells like potato chips. And these are the normal. Matthew, try some. Whoops. It is not the ripple one, it's the normal. It's like, it will be a little bit biased opinion, but like, we actually haven't been to Swiss Chalet for a long time. I barely remember what the gravy tastes like.
Not the gravy.
Same difference.
It has a little bit of that tang in it.
Yeah, it's got the tanginess of it, yeah. Like, once again, if you're not Canadian, you will not understand the hype behind this restaurant chain. So, yeah. I think I bitched about it before in one of my older vlogs. Like, it's like, they started selling this rotisserie beef. I'm like, can you guys call yourself a Swiss chalet, like a chicken restaurant? And then why are you gonna put in, it's like the rotisserie beef or something. It's like, why do you guys sell beef when you're primarily known for like a chicken restaurant? It feels really messed up to me. What do you guys think? Well, mind you though, like these days, I think they sell everything now these days. Like they have the chicken and ribs combos, right? And then I think they even have fish and chips and stuff like that too, right?
I don't know about fish. I know for ribs and...
But for me, I will prefer to take Montana's over any day. Did that make sense, what I just said? I don't know. So how's everybody doing today for Saturday? For us, we are still in the process of unpacking and sorting out the stuff. From vacation, because me and Matthew, we do not have the type of job like the luxury or like other people does, can like whenever or whatever the flexible schedule to go back to work or whatever. Like every time that we go on vacation, it takes us like forever to unpack and get ready again. And it's like, because we basically would jump right back into work. Back into our real life, working life. And if you like to believe me or not that I really work, like I don't know what to tell you about. YouTube is not the only thing that I do, guys. So for me, the next exciting thing for us to do that I want to do is, since I got back from vacation this week at work, they kept on asking me to take on extra hours here and there, stuff like that. And then so I double checked on the schedule now. And I realized ever since the first day back from vacation, my next day off is not till Tuesday. What day of the week is Tuesday? The what? 21st or?
Tuesday would be the 22nd.
The 22nd. So basically, since back from vacation, I am working 7 days straight. And they're all the pretty nice shifts, like, they're not too bad. And also, just to let you guys know, well, you guys probably know by now, I do not have those 9-to-5 type of jobs. But you know these days, who really has those type of jobs anyways these days? like out here in Calgary, like even like the banks, like there's not even really bankers' hours anymore. Like even some banks are open on Sundays now. So who knows anymore these days? Or I know there can be those type of jobs out there, like even if you're not in your office, your responsibilities, and if you get any... If you get any, like, important phone calls or emails or something, you still have to respond to them and you're, like, never really switched off. I know that out there, there's some type of jobs out there that's like that, too. And also, there's another exciting news, like I mentioned it in my vlog. But I know some people do not like to watch vlogs, and some people do not like to watch mukbangs, vice versa. So I'm gonna mention it here as well. It's like, our neighborhood that we're living in now is turning into danger, danger. It's like, hey, you added a piece of bone in the chicken. Almost broke my teeth. You added a piece of bone. If this was a restaurant, guys, it's gonna like, refund, refund.
Shut up.
Our neighborhood is getting so dangerous. It's like so many stuff is opening at the mall that is nearby our house. Like we are even getting a McDonald's. Yeah! And I can actually take the bus there. Danger, danger. Because for the longest time ever in our area where we are in the city, there is not really much newer standalone McDonald's locations that is near us. It's like only the one near my work and the one that is inside the Walmart nearby. And that's about it. So in many years, this is the first new McDonald's that is opened in a long, long time. And I'm so excited. But the one thing now that really annoys me now is I only just had the one chance to go to McDonald's when we went to vacation in Florida. I only had the iced coffee just once, and I still never had the chance to have my pumpkin spice iced coffee. It just makes me so sad every time I look at the Canadian menu and it's just a plain iced coffee and no choice. Well, I lied. They do have a vanilla and they do have caramel. That's all they have. But I want my hazelnut iced coffee. I want my pumpkin spice iced coffee.
Yeah, shut up.
Mmm. if they can move the American menu up to the Canadian menu with the iced coffee and then keep the poutine for Canadian McDonald's, that would be perfect. And maybe you guys, Americans, can demand for the poutine at McDonald's too. And we're gonna be even, right? We're gonna be even. Because in the Canadian McDonald's, we have poutine. You can upgrade your fries to poutine. And like I said, the American viewers, the only place I know that guarantee you guys can have poutine now is that in the Disney Springs, the new name for Downtown Disney. They opened a poutine place there now. So that is the one place I know for sure that you guys can have poutine there. Just to let you guys know. It almost sort of just tastes like a ketchup chips, doesn't it? Really similar to ketchup chips. Oh, I forgot that the in the American ones, you guys do not have ketchup chips, right? Yeah, it's almost a little bit tangy. And it almost tastes like ketchup chips. Because doesn't that gravy have like tomato stuff in it anyways? Ooh, now after the burp, I can taste the gravy now. Yeah, these chips are okay. Right, I won't be rushing to buy them again. Uh-oh. I got a piece of chip stuck in my side of the teeth now. Now it's out now, I'm fine. I am wondering if I'm still able to take it up on the offer of the new McDonald's that's open near our house because they have a free coffee promotion, but working every day is like not going to be able to make it to the McDonald's. Because I think it's a new location and they're just promotion and just trying to promotion for the free coffee and stuff like that. Did they say that you have to buy anything for the free coffee? So they just give you a free, like, was it a small coffee? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be able to take it up on the offer, though, even though I'd love to. How do you like those chips, Matthew? Yoo-hoo.
Weird tang.
To me, it sort of reminds me about like it's like a ketchup chips or something. Not quite, but almost, yeah. Ooh! All right, guys, and so welcome to my new subscribers, and don't forget I got a mukbang video playlist, and I got a playlist of all my older videos. And I found a bone in my chicken wraps, a chicken bone, and I'll be seeing you guys soon.